Hey everyone, in today's video, I'm going to be taking a look at SpeedCubeShop's brand new lube, and it is called Stardust. So I'm going to be testing out with two of these non-magnetic Meylongs right here. So Stardust is SpeedCubeShop's first ever water-based lubricant. All the other lubricants, for example, Martian, you know, Cosmos, Weight 5, all of these other lubricants are silicone-based. Silicone lubricants are generally a lot thicker, so this is a water-based lube, and if you look at the bubble, you can see how quickly it just moves about the cube. And if I get another silicone-based lube, for example, a Luna, which is the fastest one SpeedCubeShop has, you can see that even though this is a really fast lube, if you just observe this bubble here, even though it does move pretty quickly, you can see that it still moves sluggishly as compared to how quickly this moves. It's almost as if it's like water. Whereas for this, it sort of is like a thick jelly, maybe honey-like liquid. So I'm going to be taking a look at Stardust today. Alright, so let's just open one of these non-magnetic Meylongs real quick. And now unfortunately, this is a non-magnetic version. I didn't feel like getting a magnetic version, so it doesn't really turn very well. It's a little bit tight, so I think in order for me to really test out these loops, let me just open the other one real quick. So I'm going to be using this as sort of a comparison. So I think what I'm going to have to do first is that I'm going to have to loosen these cubes a bit so that they're slightly more usable, and then I can use the Stardust to test. Yeah, alright, so I know these Meylongs have a little bit of factory lube inside. Now, there isn't really a lot, but I'm sure there is a slight amount of factory lube, and I'm really not going to bother cleaning that out. First of all, you know, I'm a bit lazy. And second of all, I don't really expect everyone who uses Stardust to just clean out their lubes entirely, you know, beforehand. So, I feel like it wouldn't be right if I just cleaned it out and then just reviewed this lube based solely on testing it on a cube that already has been cleaned off lube. Alright, there we go. It took me ages to open one of the center caps. I guess maybe it's just a bit too tight, so I'm having a hard time getting my finger in there. Alright, so I loosened both of these Meylongs, and yeah, so right now they feel pretty much identical. They feel extremely similar. Now obviously these aren't like amazing cubes. They are still worth like only $3 or $4, so I obviously don't expect the turning to be, you know, great or anything. But all right so for this one, I'm just gonna apply a little bit of Stardust. So let's just open it up, and then we just open this, and then I just put this here, and I'll squeeze maybe a few drops here. All right then I'll turn it over. And maybe I'll put a few more drops over here. Alright, let's break it in. Oops, a little bit seeped onto the outside. Let me just clean that real quick. Oh wow, that speeded up really quickly. Wow, that's actually really impressive. And wait a minute. This cube smells really weird now. According to a lot of other people, this smells like bubblegum, but I can't really, you know, vouch for that because I don't really eat bubblegum, and you're not really allowed to buy bubblegum in Singapore anyway. So let's just test this out. Now obviously this isn't going to turn into like a flagship cube or anything, but it is pretty impressive. You know, this loop did speed this cube up really quick, and yeah, it feels way quicker now and way more responsive. And let's take a look at this one. Oh yeah, this feels super sluggish now by comparison. Alright. Oh yeah, and it also sort of quietens the cube a bit. Let me just let you listen to the sound of the cube. It makes it sound a bit more satisfying. And this is a bit more, you know, clicky or scratchy, so Yeah, I'm really liking the feel of what this Stardust is doing to this cube. I'm actually really impressed. You know, I might actually just add one more drop because I didn't really add that much. So let's just add a little bit more. Alright, I think one to two drops, I think that's more than enough. Oh god, I am horrible at applying loop. So yeah, okay, I am totally loving this. This is amazing. Alright, so one of the setups the SpeedCubeShop recommended me was to actually use a combination of Luna and Stardust. So I have Luna, I'm going to apply a bit as well, because according to SpeedCubeShop, applying Luna and Stardust makes it have a slightly more long lasting and plush feel. So let's try it out. This is the Cuberzz Stardust, right? Okay, this is definitely the Cuberzz Stardust. Alright, let's take the Luna. I'm not gonna apply too much, maybe just 2 or 3 drops. So there we go. 1 drop there and maybe 1 drop here. And if it's not enough, I'll just add more later. Alright, let's work it in. Oh yeah, I'm liking this a lot actually. Yeah, the lube is actually working in extremely nicely. Yeah, and it just flows so well. Like, the turning is just really quick and satisfying. Like, when you combine it with Luna, if it really does what they say, and it really does make this a long-lasting feel, this is actually going to be one of my favorite setups. Like, I just love what it did to the main long. Like, just listen. And listen to this. It's so much more soft and satisfying to hear and turn, obviously. And it just turns way quicker and it turns really smoothly as well. Like, I'm not getting as many lockups. I mean, obviously I will still get a few lockups. I mean, this is a $4 cube without magnets. But for a cube without magnets, like, out of the box, all I did was add a little bit of Stardust and a bit of Luna, and it turns amazingly. So now, I know a lot of you people here are going to wonder, alright, I know Stardust is probably a really great lube, but have you tried DNM-37? So DNM-37 is a lube which is also water-based, and it's also designed to be extremely fast. But it's from a different store, it's from thecubicle.com. So here it is, this is DNM-37. So I'm going to apply it to this cube, and then maybe we can compare it afterwards. So I'm just going to put a few drops in the cube. Oh, that looks kind of weird, but oh well. And on this side as well, I'm going to add 2 more drops. And if it ever feels a bit dry afterwards, I'll just add 2 more drops. Alright, I think that should be enough. Let's work it in. Okay, wait a minute. I don't really... Yeah, this is... Okay, so I think... Okay, just based on my first sort of impression... Oops, oh god. Based on my first sort of impressions... Okay, I think I have sort of a... what's it called? Comparison in mind. Okay, I do think that DNM-37 brings more raw speed, but I don't really like the feel of it. Like, it just makes the cube feel way too uncontrollable, and it's just locking up way too much. Like, honestly, okay, maybe if it's like a really, really, really slow cube, DNM-37 could help. But to be honest, nowadays, cubes aren't really that slow. Like, this is a $3 Meilong 3x3 out of the box with no magnets, and it felt horrible. Like, it was really slow, and this is way, way too fast. Like, I'm not able to control this at all. Like, that's a U3. That's almost a U3. Yeah, I'm getting, like, pretty much U3s, and all I did was add, like, a few drops of DNM. I think did I add 2 or 3? Okay, I added 3 drops. I added 2 here and then 1 on the other side, so... Comparing to the Stardust... Okay, I'm sorry, guys. I know I might be biased because I am sponsored by SpeedCubeShop, but... I think I will have to go for this one, which is the Stardust one, and Luna. Yeah, this is just way too hard for me to control. Like, I'm overshooting way too much, and I'm also locking up. Like, it's honestly, like, it's way too hard for me to control this. Now, DNM-37, okay, I think it does bring slightly more raw speed. But when it comes to actual practicality, like, to be honest, I really don't see this being very useful. Like, so basically what it does, it just makes the cube way too fast. And even though it is really fast, I don't like the feel of this. Like, this, even though it's fast, it still feels a little bit dry. I mean, I don't want to put it that way. I don't want to, like, you know, just say that the lube is dry, but it doesn't feel, it feels way too uncontrollable. And it is kind of smooth, but honestly, it's just way too fast for me. And then for the Stardust. Okay, now even though this did speed up the cube a lot, this is definitely controllable. And the thing about this Stardust slash Luna combination is that it sort of gives the cube a sort of soft plush feeling, and yeah, it's really satisfying to turn. So what I did was I added, for this one, I added 3 drops of DNM, and then for this one, I added, 4 drops of Stardust, and then afterwards, I added a bit of Luna. So, and even without Luna, I do feel like this cube was very nice. So yeah, I would personally recommend this setup. And the DNM-37, okay, I know some people might like it, but to be honest, it's just a bit too fast for me. Like, I know you can add a slow lube and then a fast lube like DNM, but to be honest, I don't really understand why you would go through the effort of just slowing down the cube so much just so you can put a lube like DNM-37 and just make it way faster. Like, to be honest, I think you're going to be better off by using this setup. Like, if you have a cube that is a bit slow, then I would definitely recommend this setup. Like, this cube has sped up amazingly. It's not too fast like this cube, but I keep overshooting. Like, honestly, I think this has a great balance between speed and control. But if you ever find that this setup is a little bit too slow, you could just add a bit more Stardust. And if you want it to last longer, just add a little bit of Luna. And I do think that this Luna will actually help make it last longer. So I'm going to use this cube for a while, and then I'm going to come back and give you guys my final thoughts in a bit. Alright, so I've been testing out these two cubes, the one looped with Luna and Stardust, as well as the one that I looped with DNM-37. And yeah, to be honest, the one that is looped with Stardust and Luna, it is definitely lasting very long. I've been using these cubes for a couple of days, and I've done many solves. Now, I know that just doing a couple hundred solves might not be a true testament to whether or not this lube lasts very long, but to be honest, I think that after 100 solves, given that this lube is still holding up very well, I do think that this is going to be extremely long lasting. And even after I used it more and more, it didn't really slow down at all. It just stayed the same ridiculous speed, and I still have trouble controlling it. Overall, I much prefer the feel of Stardust. Like, the feel of DNM-37 is just really fast, and it makes the cube feel a bit slippery, and it's not as smooth or plush feeling as the Stardust. When Stardust is combined with Luna, the final result is honestly amazing, and I would definitely recommend you guys try out this setup as well. According to SpeedCubeShop, this mixes extremely well with all of the other silicone lubes like Martian and controllers, so if you guys have these lubes, I'll definitely recommend you guys try out a few of these combinations. Alright, so that's it for my review on the new Stardust lube. Hopefully you guys found it useful. Make sure to join my Discord server, link in the description. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.